Hello y'all, this is Kaiser Redux, a mod for Hearts of Iron 4, based in the Kaiserai universe, but it adds a lot of different country paths and new countries, and it puts more of an emphasis on fun and sort of interesting scenarios instead of focusing overall on realism and grounded lore. We're going to play as the Socialist Republic of Italy, who is syndicalist and controls the southern part of the Italian peninsula. For national spirits, we have Divided Nation, Guardi Rossi, Organized Crime, Reliance on the French, and the Unpopular Chairman. Our military is not too bad. We have 16 divisions in our army, and the Navy is quite sizable. We even have an aircraft carrier, and our Air Force is just planes on the aircraft carrier. For the military research, we have up-to-date infantry equipment and motorized. The artillery, we might need to improve that a little bit, and 1934 light tanks. And for the Air Force, we're up-to-date on close air support and naval bombers. For our military commanders, we have a lot of generals and two field marshals for the Army. And for the Navy, we have a lot of admirals. Let's just leave it at that. Our long-term goal is to unite Italy by beating the Italian Federation in a war. Italy was a loser in World War I, and that will explain the existence of the Italian Federation and the Socialist Republic of Italy, which is who we're playing as. We want to unite Italy, but the main issue with that is, despite having the backing of France and Britain, it may summon the wrath of Germany and Austria. With that said, we are a member of the Third International in the starting year of 1936. We got some events. Mussolini wants to talk with Mazzoli, but more importantly, we get the legacy of the Sicilian Workers League, giving us 20 political power. The Socialist Italian Infantry do have their own models, but more concerning is we get an event about the Legion gaining power, who are led by Julius Evola. So Aurelian's elected in France, Black Monday, and the fascist revival is taking place. That is, I believe, the Sicilian Workers League that is trying to pop up again. An event, the Noble Legion of the Awakening, that is the group led by Julius Evola. Let's warn their donors, even though that will cost us some political power. Assist to army focus is completed. We gotta choose our choice here. Let's go with support the Red Guards, even though they're more like militia in terms of structure. The fasci are rallying support. We can't be having that, so let's give aid to the peasantry in Sicily. Because we supported the Red Guard, that will put us on their path in the military part of the focus tree. Evola has expanded his high secret society, the UR group, and we're going to investigate them and the Legion, even if it will cost us more. Event time, socialist victory in Russia, and Pius XI has died. Peasants want more support. We'll do it only because we want to curb the influence of the fasci even more. After a failed attempted murder of a World War veteran turned mystic, we'll move on Evola and arrest him. Evola evades arrest and goes underground, so let's assign some investigators on him. The southern Italian peasants are appeased, so that will end the issue and the threat of the fasci revival. It's official, the internal fascist opposition in our country against the government is defeated and will no longer be a problem. A founder of the Italian Socialist Party, Filippo Turati, dies at the age of 79, giving us 20 political power. Let's get started on one of the most important focuses of the Socialist Republic of Italy, begin the Fourth Congress. It has started and the various factions in the Congress will be debating on economic, internal, and military policies. For the economic policy, let's go with the radical socialist option of expanding our agriculture. Internal policy, let's go with the syndicalism choice and focus on empowering the unions. Now for the religious policy, let's go with the totalist option and support state atheism in this part of Italy. No majority achieved, no one faction won in the Congress, so to speak. We lost some base stability, but this was the outcome we were after. The Congress has failed, the March on Naples has begun. Let's have the Mafia take charge of the crumbling state. The country color changes to yellow, we're now called the State of Sicily and Naples, and Calogero Fassini is the new leader. Calogero Fassini in our history was a Sicilian Mafia boss and became one of the most influential and legendary bosses on the island after World War II until his death in 1954. The media often depicted the man as a boss of bosses, although that position does not exist in the Cosa Nostra, also known as the Sicilian Mafia. With the Mafia in power, that completes the Mafia state focus, making available to us the other focuses in the tree. Pius XII is elected as a new pope. Let's check out his branch of the Italian Federation focus tree. He would be able to condemn syndicalism and put forts on the border, but fortunately, we aren't syndicalists anymore. We could condemn the new pope, but let's try to maybe come to terms with him instead. In our nation, corruption has become the bedrock of the state, giving us base stability and improving the popularity of paternal autocracy. Instead of criminals govern criminals, let's go with a mafia law enforcement. We open operations in the north and begin preparations for the eventual war with the Italian Federation above us. The worker priest movement event appears, we get more political power and radical socialism popularity goes up because Jesus was a carpenter after all. Checking in on Russia, they join the Third International and Georgi Surkov is in power, and that is one big transamir. Radical socialism just keeps on getting more popular. Venice has appeared, but they are a puppet of the Austrian Empire, and Fiume nearby is led by a certain Hungarian admiral. With the mafia in charge, banks have adjusted to this new way of life, becoming useful for wide-scale money laundering, giving us more base stability and a new civilian factory. Even though they control all of southern Italy now, Sicily will always be a stronghold for the mafia. The construction industry of the mafia is expanding both home and abroad. Let's go with the focus on abroad option, giving us political power and a civilian factory. The American Civil War is in full swing, but oddly, the Pacific States of America have renounced their claims. What are you doing, Henry H. Arnold? The war is not looking so good for Omar Bradley and Douglas MacArthur, who is stuck in Washington, D.C. We're getting closer to our war with the North, but first we gotta complete and enforce the Code of Honor. We have an iron grip over the country, and for anyone who opposes us, they will have to deal with our forces in the Mafia and the National Army. Bulgaria is fighting Serbia, and they seem to be winning, I think, and the Ottoman Empire is fighting nearly all of their neighbors. In our country, at a price, the wealthy are able to acquire cars, narcotics, fashion, and wine. You know, they will have to fork over some cash, but it does give us some political power and a civilian factory. High profile assassinations. We get more political power, but there is a loss of 5 manpower in our nation and in the Italian Federation. We have become the illicit state where corruption is everywhere. Citizens can buy narcotics from the government, and protection rackets are accepted as taxes. In Europe, the Kingdom of Spain seems to be winning their civil war, and the Batavian Commune is being dogpiled by the Germans and their allies. Liquefied Northern Law and Order is completed, and we declare war on the Italian Federation. Rome is heavily defended, so we're going to try and send some troops around it. The Russian Socialist Republic is fighting Transamir, and we're advancing deeper. 4 Italian Federation divisions were encircled, and that would be a huge blow to their manpower. Rome has fallen. Sicilian troops belonging to us have taken the internal city. One of our divisions were cut off, so we are trying to move fast and save them. The Kingdom of Canada decides to intervene in the American Civil War. The Italian Federation troops are going to get surrounded. The conflict is won and will be sure to take all states. It's beautiful. The Italian peninsula has been reunited and Italy is whole once more. We have some special decisions. We will restore order in Latium and take a couple others as well. We have unified Italy. We can either give the Pope free reign or the second choice, send the Pope back to Rome and proclaim a new Italy. Let's go with the second and become the state of Italy. Our country colors change again, this time to a dark green, and we get a new flag. Negotiate an axis, focus is done, and we create our own faction, the Axis of Bosses. The Mongol Empire rises from the graveyard. That's a little ominous. Let's see what's going on in Mongolia. And let's find out. Sternberg has become Genghis Khan II. The video is going to end here. If you enjoyed the mod, make sure to check it out in the description below. If you enjoyed the video, make sure to like and subscribe. Leave a comment. Have an awesome day. I'll see y'all later. Bye.